Hi friends, today I am going to show you a step-by-step process to create this speedometer using just HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Let's start. First, let me create an index.html file here. And inside that, let me use a HTML5 template. I am changing the title. And let me also create a style.css and link that to here. Inside the style.css, let me first reset the margin, padding, and use box sizing border box. Okay, first let me start with a container div. For the speedometer container, let me give 300 pixel width, 300 pixel height, and border 3 pixel solid black. Okay, let me give border radius 50%, and so it will be a circle. And margin 50 pixel auto, so that it comes in the center. Finally, position relative, because we are going to position the other elements relative to this container. Okay, inside speedometer container, let me create a div with class center point. For this center point, let me give width 20 pixel, height 20 pixel, and background color black. And let me give border radius 50% to make it a circle. Now I need to position this exactly center to this circle. So let me use position absolute. And we know the container width is 300 pixel and we are using a border of 3 pixel. And so it is going to take 3 pixel in the left and 3 pixel in the right from the total width. So remaining width is going to be 294 pixel. Our center point width is going to be 20 pixel. And so, if I reduce that from the total width, it is going to be 274 pixel. Half of that is 137 pixel. So, if I give top 137 pixel and left 137 pixel, it will be positioned in the exact center. Okay, let's create the scales. For that, let me create a div first with class speedometer scale. For this class, let me give width 8 pixel, height 280 pixel, and background color black. I need to position this also relative to the container. So let me use position absolute. The width of the scale is 8 pixel and we know already we are using 6 pixel as border for the container. So we lost 14 pixel and the remaining width is going to be 286 pixel. Half of that is going to be 143 pixel. So I can use left 143 pixel to position this in center. And as we have used the height as 280 pixel plus border 6 pixel, which is going to be 286 pixel, and so the remaining height is 14 pixel. Half of that is 7 pixel. So if I use top 7 pixel, this will be positioned vertically center. Now I can use the transform property to rotate it to minus 90 degree. Actually my idea is to create scales from 0 to 180. So totally I need 19 scales. I can separate each by 10 degrees. So let me create 19 divs with unique classes. And for the first div, let me use rotate minus 90 degree. For the second div, minus 80 degree. Like that, let me quickly rotate all the 19 divs. And so we can see this. Now let me create a div with class speedometer center hide, which I can use to hide the center part. For this class, let me use width 250 pixel, height 250 pixel. Let me give a background color so that we can see this div. Okay, let me use border radius 50% and so it will become a circle. Now let me position this using position absolute and same calculation. 300 minus 6, which is equal to 294, minus 250, which gives 44. Half of that is 22. So top 22 pixel and left 22 pixel. Now it comes to the center. Let me use the set index to bring this to the front and change the background color to white. Our center point is behind this white circle. Let us use set index to bring that also to the front. Okay, Now let me add another div with class speedometer bottom height, and to this class let me use width 320 pixel, height 250 pixel and a background color. Let me use position absolute and set index to bring this to the front. And let me give top 10 pixel and left 10 pixel for now, and then let me inspect and adjust the position. Top 160 pixel and left minus 14 pixel seems to be good. Okay, let me change the background color and add a border top of 1 pixel solid. Looks good. Let's concentrate on the arrow. For that, let me create a container first. And inside that, let me create a wrapper. Because we need a wrapper to use position relative, so that we can position the arrow relative to this wrapper. Inside that wrapper, let me create the arrow div. And for the arrow container, let me use width 160 pixel, height 160 pixel, and a background color. Let me use position absolute and set index to bring this to the front. To bring this to the center, I need to calculate 294 pixel minus 160 pixel, which gives me 134 pixel, and half of that is 67 pixel. So let me use top 67 pixel and left 67 pixel. For the arrow wrapper, let me use the same width and height as the container. And let me change the arrow container background color to transparent and arrow wrapper background color to red. Here let me use position relative so that I can position the arrow relative to this wrapper. For the arrow class, let me give width 110 pixel, height 4 pixel and a nice background color. Let me change this wrapper color also to transparent and use position absolute in the arrow class to position it correctly. Let me use top 10 pixel and left 10 pixel first. And then let me inspect this and position this correctly. Top 78 pixel and left minus 30 pixel seems to be good. Actually, the idea is when I rotate the wrapper, the arrow will also rotate. So let me add a new class speed-0. And for this class, let me use transform property with rotate 0 degrees. Let me also create the other classes and use the respective value for rotate. So if I change this class, you can see it is moving. It would be good if you add some transition. Now looks good. Okay, let's create the buttons to increase and decrease the speed. For that, let me create a new container. And inside that, let me create two buttons. Let me also add some classes. For the buttons inside the container class, let me give width 200 pixel, height 60 pixel. The other container is hiding these buttons. And so let me use margin top to the accelerate container and text align center. And for the buttons, let me use border none, border radius 5 pixel, margin 20 pixel. Also, let me use font size 18 pixel and font weight bold. Finally, let me add cursor pointer and a box shadow. When the button is active, let me change the color of the box shadow so that we will get a click effect. Now let's change the color of the buttons. For increase, let me add a background color of green and for decrease, let me use red. And finally, let me change the font color to white. Okay, our buttons are ready. Now we need to add our logic. Let's create a JavaScript file called logic.js and let's use it here, just before the closing body tag. And let me also add onClick events to these buttons. And create the respective functions. Let me create a global variable speed equal to 0. And let me increase the speed inside increase speed function and let me decrease it in the decrease speed function. We have speed range from 0 to 180. And so I need to add a logic to prevent increasing the speed beyond 180 and prevent decreasing the speed below 0. Okay, actually on clicking these buttons, I need to dynamically calculate the speed and add a class to the speedometer arrow wrapper div. And so the arrow moves. So let me create a new function called add class. And let me call this function inside both increase and decrease functions. In the add class function, let me create a variable new class equal to speed hyphen speed like this. Initially, you can see I have a class. This is what I need to replace. So let me create another global variable to hold the previous speed. Inside this class, let me create a new local variable previous class to hold the current class. And let me create another variable EL and get the speedometer arrow wrapper element using the getElementsByClassName function. And then I am checking whether the class list of that element contains the previous class. If it contains the class, let me remove and add the new class. Finally, after I change the class, let me assign the new speed to the previous speed. So if I click the increase button, we can see the speed is increasing. And when I click the decrease button, it is decreasing. If I inspect, we can see on clicking the buttons, the class is getting changed. That is why the arrow is moving. Okay, now let me add an active class dynamically and add some color to the scales ranging from green to red when it is active. For that, first let me create a global variable current scale equal to 1. And let me increase that inside increase speed function and decrease that inside decrease speed function. And then let me create a function change active, in which let me create a temp class using the current scale. And using the temp class, let me get the element and toggle the active class in that element. Let me also call this function inside both increase speed and decrease speed. Now if I inspect and click the button, we can see a new class is getting added. Let me add background colors to these classes. For scale 1 having active class, let me use background color green. And for scale 2, let me use a lighter green. And then slowly to yellow. And then to orange. And finally to red. Let me test it. We can see the initial one is still black. So let me use the active class for the initial one. But even after that, it is black. That is because the last scale is overlapping this one. If I inspect, we can understand that. When I hide that element, we can see it is showing green. So for this 19th scale, let's use a lesser height and let's position that so that it won't hide this first scale. Okay, let me use these values. Now we can see the green is showing up. So when I increase it, we can see it is fine. But when I decrease it, the last one is not changing back to black. And the first one is changed. So here in increase speed, it is correct. But inside decrease speed, first we have to change the active color and then decrease the current scale. And so if I test now, we can see it is working as expected. Finally, let me add some text. Let me create a div for that. Inside that, let me have a static div in which let me have speed and then a dynamic div. Inside the dynamic div, let me have a span with class km in which let me mention 0 and another span with class unit where I am having kmph. That means kilometer per hour. In CSS, for this speedometer text class, let me give some width, a temporary background color and position absolute with some z index. Let me inspect and position it. These values seem to be fine. Let me use that. And let me use text align center and font weight bold. Let me remove the background color. And for the static class, let me use font size 18 pixel. For the dynamic class, let me use margin top 10 pixel. And for the KM class, let me use font size 32 pixel so that it appears big. Finally, for the unit class, let me use font size 14 pixel and margin left 5 pixel. Finally, let me create a function changeText in which let me get the element by class name KM. And let me use inner text property to add the speed. And let me also call this function in both increase and decrease speed functions. Okay, looks good. So we have created a speedometer using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Hope you like this video. Please subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.